a disciple, that at the end of this public lecture, we will have something to take home with the commitment to be patriotic citizens, youths of our dear country. Even though I am asked to give the welcome address, permit me to start by that a little to say that Nigerian problem is with us, and it is only us that can rise up to solve it accordingly. That Nigeria is a great nation with so many potentials, both natural and human, in an understatement. Therefore, for the country to sustain its greatness to an available heart, we must begin to do things that speak good of our country to the international community. We must look inward to see what we want, we went wrong, and how we can correct the ills that have enabled us as a people. It is a known fact that without peace and stability, no society will develop and attain the common goals of the people. Our governments need to put necessary infrastructures in place that will aid the realization of our common goals. As it is today, the Nigerian situation has grown to the worst stage that if nothing is totally done to address the numerous social ills in our society, we will wake up someday to hear that Nigeria is no more, God forbid. Our government at all levels needs to be drastic on some of the issues confronting us as a nation, which borders on bad governance, unemployment, poverty, falling standard of education, increased cases of insecurity, and so on, which I consider as attributes to why most Nigerian youths decided to engage in violent acts, restiveness, banditry, hooliganism, and kidnapping. Most more disturbing was the recent NSAS protests across the country, where many assets, both public and private, were destroyed. And most of the participants of the protests are youths. Just a few days ago, precisely last week, some youths, most of whom are students of the Isa Mustafa Agoi Polytechnic, in last year, by the keeper, the only highway leading to the southern northern parts of the country, including FCT, and damage on public and private properties. Perhaps, if we, the youths, are sensitive and patriotic enough to know the gravity of damage, or the damage cost, they will know that the losses will affect them in future. It is important to note that the youth, or rather young persons, the world over, are a virtual players and important segment of the society that we live in. Until we shift away from the occurrences of acts of violence and lawlessness, we will be far away from things that will entrench national peace, stability, and development. Let me also make bold to say that our government should rise up to its responsibility of ensuring good governance, corrupt-free society, provide jobs, and create platforms that will engage the youth into useful venture. There will be no unpatriotic youths in Nigeria, because the youths will have no option to be patriotic. Whereas those who are hell bent to criminalities will have no place to operate. Let me conclude this by saying that it is all our collective responsibility to make Nigeria great and better again. Thank you all, and God bless you.
Thank you. At this juncture, I would like to invite the President SUG to just tell us a word or two, because this is a program for you. So in his capacity, we believe there is one or two things he would like to say as far as giving a message. Please come forward. A round of applause for him, please, once again, as he comes forward, the SUG President of Nigeria.
I want, on behalf of the entire student of Nazareth State University, KEPI, appreciate this noble organization for finding the institution worthy to hold this program. And we want to also assure you that for choosing to hold this program here, it has reignited our support, and it has also renewed our commitment towards supporting this organization and also other youth organizations cut across this country. Permit me to say this. Whenever I have chance to speak, especially when it has to do with Nigerian students and the youth entirely, I don't forget to say this. The youth of this 21st century, especially the Nigerian as a case study, we are lagging behind. Let me tell you, the government didn't do anything wrong when it comes to youth leadership, youth inclusiveness and leadership. I stand to be corrected, but you will bear with me that in time past, when you look at the youth as of then, in time before 1960, I'm a historian, and I will relate this to you, and you will understand what I'm saying. In time before 1960 in Nigeria, you will understand that the quality of youth we are having as of them, we don't have them now. Abubakar Tafa Balewa, he was in House of Reps at the age of 27. Chief Anthony Inahoro, who called for the self-governance of Nigeria, did that at the age of 28 at the British Parliament. If you look at so many people who were actually activists then, they did that at their early age. Now, can we come back to our age? How many of our youth at that kind of age limit can be very, very audible enough, can be psychologically sound to propose solutions to the dilapidated nature of our country? If we look at ourselves today, the youth at our level, we still limit ourselves to beggars. We still limit ourselves to societal issues, to people who are still problems to the society, instead of being solution to the society. I want to urge you that if you are here and you are about to acquire your degree, you should know that you are already part of the solution of the society, not a problem to the society. I want to assure you that your degree is not just to give you food on the table, but your degree is also an opportunity for you to contribute your quota to the development of the country. And finally, I want to say this. I want to challenge Nigeria as a country. Nigeria can never step forward until we have one person who is ready to stand for Nigeria. Because it is said that for anything to stand, there must be somebody who will stand. You can bear with me, some of you who are knowledgeable than I do. Those countries that are doing well today, if you observe very well, there is one person who has stood for that nation. Can you talk about an American? You cannot talk about America without mentioning Abraham Lincoln. Can you talk about Ghana? You cannot talk about Ghana without mentioning Dr. Kwame Nkrumah. Can you talk about Kenya? You cannot talk about Kenya without mentioning people like Uhuru Kenyatta. Can you talk about Tanzania without mentioning people like Julius Nyerere? Can you talk about Tunisia without mentioning people like even Kalidou? Can you talk about Singapore without mentioning people like Nico Hill? Can you talk about South Africa without mentioning people like Nelson Mandela? Now, in Nigeria, who are we going to mention? That is the question we need to ask ourselves. Whom are we going to mention as a country? That is where I think if we will have somebody who will stand for Nigeria, Nigeria will progress. And it's possible it can be you, it can be I standing here. You are not just for, just as I say, those people start at their tender age, and you can also do that. Thank you very much, and I pray that some of this gathering and organization would be a point of recognition to our commitment into providing solution to our dilapidated nature of the country. God bless us, and we pray to have a successful state. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.